Hello everyone, this is Mr. Reliable here and today we're going to be talking about a science fiction film called Elysium. Let's save your time and money. So, in the near future, the Earth is no longer a desirable place to live due to pollution created by human civilization. Humanity has never been more divided by their economic status. The rich have built themselves a space station, called Elysium, where life is perfect without disease nor death. They're essentially gods. They isolate themselves from Earth, using it as nothing more than a means of production, and the people living here are nothing more than their slaves. The main character, Maximum, leaves his criminal past behind and tries to work in a decent job, but still gets harassed by the robot police due to his criminal record. They break his arm for being disobedient, which sends him to the hospital. To his surprise, Max sees his childhood friend Fry, who he promised to bring to Elysium with him. One day, she works in the hospital as a nurse now, and Max doesn't waste a second asking her out, which is exactly what I would have done as well. She's reluctant about it, but doesn't want Max to break his other arm. So that he can see her again, Max almost lost his job with his injury, where he manufactures robotic parts for weapons company, ran by their CEO John, a citizen of Elysium. The only way to go to Elysium is illegally by paying your life saving to a man named Spider, who runs an underground organization that sends shadows to the space station. But the trip is extremely risky, as Elysium would do anything to keep the people out. Defense Secretary Delacorte orders a missile strike from her sleeper agent Cougar, which he fires on Earth, destroying two of the transport shadows while missing the last one. The ship manages to land and the people run towards the closest medbay, using their counterfeit tattoos to heal their sickness. The success rate is extremely low, as only one mother was able to heal her daughter from her crippled nose. One day, while Max is working in his factory, a malfunction occurs to the doors, which delays his entire line. The foreman threatens him to go in at the prospect of losing his job. Max chooses to obey, but the door shuts, locking him inside. Despite the workers trying to save him, it was too late and he took a full dose of radiation from the machines. A robot drags him out and tells him to sign a waiver, which gives him some medicine that will keep him functioning until his death 5 days. From now that disregards for, the worker is very apparent and the CEO seems to care more about the bed sheets being cleaned than about his worker being alive. Max goes home ere his best friend Julio sees that something is very wrong. Max tells him that he has to go to Elysium, where they have the technology necessary to fix him. The only person that can make this happen is Spider, but even with all his friend's money, it won't be enough for a ticket. Max goes to Spider demanding a ticket and ID, and promises to pay him back however much the amount is. Spider laughs at him and says that he gets many people asking the same thing every day. Max pulls out a knife to threaten him and is clearly unafraid to die. Spider realizes that Max is dying and offers him a job where he cannot refuse, since none of his men are crazy enough to go through with it. They plan to hijack the organic information from a citizen of Elysium who visits Earth and use this to acquire money from their bank accounts. Max agrees to the plan, but the man said they go after John, the CEO, who cares so little about his workers' lives. Spider sees that Max is weak from the sickness and takes out an exosuit, which requires surgery to put on. Max has little choice but to go under the knife, as he will die soon anyways. If he doesn't, Secretary Delacorte is being reviewed by the president of Elysium for killing 46 humans and using a sleeper agent from Earth. Delacorte doesn't think what she did was wrong, as she argues that she was protecting her children and what they built for their descendants. The president gives her a final warning, and further action of similar nature will result in her removal from office. She sees an opportunity when she meets with John in the discussion of renewing their weapons contract. Delacorte threatens to remove any further contracts from their company unless John can stage a coup for her. She wants him to write a computer code that reboots the system and reinstates. For as the new president, since she believes that the current leadership puts their civilization in danger, John accepts his offer for securing the future of his company and rise to reboot sequence. putting a lethal fail-safe in case it was stolen. Max and his team wait for John to leave his office and puts a bomb on his vehicle. They detonate the bomb on their plant location and chases after the falling plane. Delacour notices what happened to John and immediately sends Cougar after him. Max and his team arrives at the location, but were not expecting a drone to attack them. The drone shoots a barrage of grenades at the team, causing them to hide behind their cars. Max manages to make an effective counter-fire as the drone reloads. Blowing it to pieces, they break open John's vehicle, and just before they can retrieve him, another drone walks out and starts firing at the team. John is shot in the exchange of gunfires on Max tackles the robot and proceeds to fight it in close combat. He manages to get an upper hand and rips its head off. They notice that John is dying and tries to quickly retrieve the information onto Maximum. They complete the transfer, but is unable to read the data due to the fail-safe that was put in place. Before they can run away, Cougar arrives and begins shooting bombs at them and killing their teammates in a sadistic manner. Cougar goes after Max personally and wounds him badly by stabbing him in the stomach. Julia tries to save Max, but ends up getting killed in the process. Max has no choice but to run from Cougar, while the agent sends drones all over the city looking for him, trying to prevent the codes from leaking out. Delacour orders a full containment of the area, jamming other signals, so that no planes can leave. Kruger's team also picked up traces of the code and realizes what its function is, motivating him to retrieve it even more, but likely for his own benefits. Max makes it to the outside of the hospital where Frame works before bleeding out and calls out her name. She tries to bring him to the hospital, but Max refuses as he'll be arrested right away. She brings him back to her home and manages to save him from the brink of death. Max sees a little girl in Friend's house and realizes that she's a mother. Fry wants Max to bring her daughter to Elysium. As she's dying from leukemia, he hesitates when he sees the kindness of the girl, but ultimately refuses. As he puts saving his own life as priority to everything else, Kruger's drones pick up the movements from Max and arrives only to find Frey and her daughter. Realizing that they helped Max recover, he takes them prisoner just in case for leverage and some personal entertainment. Maximum returns to Spider with the code only to find that they have no way of going to Elysium due to Delacour jamming the airspace. Spider looks through the code and realizes that it is the key to resetting Elysium, potentially saving all of humanity if they make everyone a citizen. Spider tries to convince Max to use this code to save humanity, but he has little interest in this as he'll die very soon. Realizing that his information is extremely valuable and that Kruger needs him alive, Max turns himself into the mercenaries so that he may go to Elysium. Max holds out a grenade and threatens Kruger with suicide. He demands to go to Elysium and use the med base right away. As he enters their ship, he realizes their Fry and her daughter are captured as well. All because of him. They notify Delacour that they have the code and she lifts the signal jam, allowing them to leave Earth. This also gives Spire an opportunity for flight as he prepares his men to go to Elysium, planning to use the code to save humanity before they can land their ship. Kruger trusts with his man to restrain Max, but their efforts fail, blowing Cougar's face apart and crashed. Landing on the ground, the mercenary still manages to apprehend Max and his friends, while Cougar's man takes their leader's body to the med bay, reconstructing his face in an effort to revive him. The scientists ties Max to the hospital bed and plans to extract the code for him in Delacour order through their conversation. Max realizes that in order to extract the code, the fail-safe would kill the original host. This means that he will not be able to save himself as he would die before Elysium can make him a citizen before they can begin the extraction. Max manages to break free in the last minute. He interrogates the scientists for Frey's whereabouts and rushes to save them before they're disposed of. Unhappy with Cougar's crash landing, which puts citizens in danger, Delacour arrives through the newly reconstructed man and continues to express her disapproval and disappointment in a moment of rage. Cougar stabs Delacour in the neck, fatally wounding her as his man throws her in with Freya and her daughter. Kruger plans to use the code for himself and orders his men to destroy all the politicians in the building. While he looks for Max personally, while still searching for Fry Maxies. The spider has arrived on the security camera and tries to contact him with the speakers. He tells Spider to use the information in his spring to transform everyone into a citizen of Elysium. As he heads off to rescue Frey and her daughter just before Kruger's men are about to do the unspeakable to Frey or threatening her daughter, Max finds them and stops the man from their horrendous actions. They all meet up with Spider and Maximum tell Spider to go with him to reset Elysium of Frey goes through the nearest medbay. Wait for the reset so she can cure her daughter after the two groups go their own ways. Kruger catches up with Max and proceeds to attack him out of vengeance. Spider tries to help in the fight, but without the EXO suit, he gets taken out easily by Kruger, who nails his hand to the floor. Max tries to defend himself, but Kruger's suit is more advanced in every way. He struggles, while Kruger throws him against the wall and tossing him like a rag doll. But for some reason, the bad guys always prefer to talk. Instead of finishing after opponents, which gives Max a chance to grab onto Kruger's neurochip and rips it out, disabling him entirely, Kruger tries to kill both of them together by using a grenade and locking onto Max's suit, but Max manages to break free and throws Kruger down the bridge while he explodes into pieces. He heads through the mainframe with Spider and gets ready to extract the code. Spider tells Max that there will be no return for him, to which Max says that he already knew. In his last breath, he tells Frey that he has kept the promise he made when they were kids, and he finally sees just how beautiful Earth really is. Max executes the codes, killing himself while shutting down the entire system. Elysium reboots and sets everyone as a citizen, including the people on Earth. Frey uses them at bay to heal her daughter, while the computer sends numerous drones to Earth, liberating everyone from their sufferings. So what do you guys think about this movie? Let me know in the comments below. And if you like my video, please press like and subscribe for more. I'll see you guys next time.